Yo, what's up guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how to make these 5 grid backgrounds in DaVinci Resolve. So let's do it. Here I've got all the backgrounds I've done and let's go to Fusion. So I'm going to show you how to make all of these backgrounds. And at the end of this video, I'm going to show you how to save these backgrounds. Then you can have them like I have on the left with the name and pictures. Okay, first grid background effect is with black. Background is on black background, and now I'm going to grab background with alpha value 0, and I copied grid from already made animation, so you can copy all parameters, and I'm going to connect this grid to this background. And now we need to go to edges and we need to choose mirror. And now, as you can see, when you move center, it goes endlessly. We just need to animate it and set it as a loop. So go to frame 0, animate center, go to frame number 300. I want to type in 0.0. And now let's see what's the speed of the grid. So it's all right. And now we're going to merge. We're going to spline editor, thick the merge. Let's make it bigger and select all points and set it as loop. Let's close spline editor, and now as you can see, even if it goes through the 300, it goes perfectly endlessly. Okay, I'm going to delete them now and let's prepare another background. So next we need to grab background with alpha 0, and I'm going to do the same as I did in the last one. So I copy this grid and I'm going to connect it to this background. And I want to make it a bit bigger. So it's like that. And this grid selected, I need rectangle mask. All right, and I want to go soft edge to 0.2. I'm going to something like this. Maybe change the zoom in the grid. Kind of like that. Okay, and now holding grid, I need to type in shift space, and I'm going to choose node which named lens distortion, and unthick RGB, have same distortion, and we're going to manipulate here, and blue distortion going down to -1, and as you can see, we've got some green, red and blue colors here. So here you can manipulate the shape of grid, so you can adjust it to your liking. Okay, next one, we need background alpha, and I'm going to do the same as last time. So I copy another grid, I'm going to connect it to this background, and you can copy parameters from here. And what I want to do is I need to type shift space and choose DVE, and I want to go with this like that, kind of like this. And for this grid, I need rectangle. I'm going to connect rectangle to this grid, and I need soft edge for that. And let's leave it in the center. And we need another rectangle. So copy, paste. Actually, I need change paint mode to add. And I'm going to somewhere like here, change the size a little bit. Okay, and now to make another one grid on the bottom. So you need to hold shift space, and that will be node name mirrors. Okay, and we need to change angle of that. So that will be 90 exactly. And to achieve what you've seen on intro, so you need to manipulate DVE. So let's change X rotation like that, and manipulating rectangle, we can change where that will be the space in between backgrounds. Okay, and I think it's fine. And my idea, like if you do some intro, let's say, let's just change background, kind of like that. Okay, and my idea, let's say if you do some animation, so for example, let's grab DaVinci yeah. And let's connect DaVinci here and transform. And let's say I'm talking about DaVinci Resolve. So I'm going to have size 0 on frame 0, and we're going to frame 100, and DaVinci is revealing from the middle of nowhere. Wow. And obviously it doesn't look good. You need to smooth it out, but you got the point, right? Okay, let's do the next one. And the same method, background alpha 0, and I'm going to paste the grid so you can copy parameters. I think that's the same as it was in the last time. And for that one, I need DVE as well. So we need to change the rotation. The rotation X, let's put it down. Okay, let's move. And to this grid, we need rectangle to have nice edges. Rectangle with soft edge. Let's make this rectangle bigger. And you need to just adjust everything. And you've got some like grid on the floor, okay? This is 3D, this is 3D effect. And what I wanna do here as well, let's move the edges at the end. So you got like depth. I wanna do something like invisible light there, something like mist. I'm gonna grab background with alpha 1 and connect it here. Now actually I need this background to be white, and I'm going to grab ellipse and hit expression here so we can connect height with width. Let's go down with that. Let's change soft edge, and I would change it to let's say 1 and put it a little bit down. Let's make this bigger. Okay, and it's kind of missed, as I said. Okay, and next and the last grid. So copy these parameters of this grid, connect this grid to the background, and I want to change size of the merge, so that will be about that. And select this grid, hold shift space, go to waviness, and we've got this node. Okay, first one is vertical, scale will be about 63, 62.2 is fine. Strength will be about that, 3.1. With face, let's go 0.8. And speed will be 0.165. And now uncheck animate, select this waviness, copy that, and type in Ctrl Shift V, and you've got instance. The instance waviness type to horizontal. The instance animate, so you can animate horizontal. Change speed to 0.2. Actually, we need to de-instance, so then we can type in 0.2, and the rest of the properties will remain the same. And we've got this background grid effect. And now I'm going to show you how to save these animations. So let's go to effects, let's go to templates, let's go to Fusion. And this is my folder where I keep all my templates which I use in Fusion. So what I want to do, I'm going to click right mouse button here to see show folder, and I'm going to create folder. And I will name it tutorial background. Okay, I will go here, I'll double click here and select all the address. I'm going to copy this. I'm going to select this nodes, right mouse button, settings, save as, and now double click in address line. Okay, I select all of them, delete this address, Control V, and we go into location when I've got this folder, which as you can see, Fusion templates, Fusion tutorial backgrounds. And I'm going to make another folder. So let's say I'm gonna name it 01 waviness background. Okay. And I'm going to select this name, copy, and I'm going to paste it here. Okay, enter. And now DaVinci needs time to process saving. Click right mouse button to save image in the viewer. And select this waviness background, hit F2, copy that, paste it here, .png, okay, and save as type, that will be png, okay, and save. And now you need to restart DaVinci. Now we're back in DaVinci. Let's go to effects, templates, fusion, and as you can see, there is tutorial background, and I've got waving as background, and there is a little picture, png picture of this background, which we just saved. When I go into grab it here to the grid and I connect it to it, works. That's how you can save it. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.